Hey guys, Crypto Dad here again, and today I'm going to explain to you why I'm still using my Ledger Nano X hardware wallet and why I chose to update it to the latest firmware. So let's get started. So there's been a lot of controversy surrounding this new Ledger Recover service and the accompanying firmware update that makes the service possible. So I've been doing a lot of soul searching over the last month or so and a reevaluation of why I still use the Ledger device and decided to go ahead and update to the latest firmware. And I did this during my live stream, and during the live stream, I had quite a few thoughts about Ledger hardware wallets, secure chip elements in the Ledger Nano X and other hardware wallets. And I'm going to kind of explain to you why I decided to keep using my Ledger and why I decided to go ahead and update my firmware. So I'm going to give you highlighted excerpts from my live stream as we went through this process. Enjoy. So a lot of people are suspicious of any kind of interface. People are very suspicious of Ledger devices now that they've come out with this new backup feature. They don't trust the process. Well, the bad news is, you know, or the wake up and smell the coffee is that hardware devices always have always relied on a certain level of trust of the end user in the way the company manages the private key and updates the internals of the device. I know we were all under the impression that they were completely cryptographically safe and secure, but they are. But the inner workings of many hardware wallets like Keystone and like Engrave are proprietary, right? You cannot see the inner workings of this. The reason why they don't make the secure chip technology open source, there's two reasons. One is that most hardware manufacturers, hardware wallet manufacturers like Trezor and Keystone and Engrave, are actually buying those secure chip elements from third-party companies, right? They don't actually make the secure chip element. They give them the specs, and then they outsource that to companies that specialize in that kind of stuff. And those companies that make these secure element chips don't want to reveal their industry secrets, right? Understandable. The second reason why they don't make the secure element chip inner workings or the firmware or wherever you want to think of it open source is because they're an open source model relies on a large development community to constantly be reviewing and updating the code. And secure element chips are very small and esoteric. And to have that sort of code being open source really doesn't make sense because you don't have enough people actually with eyes on the code. You would most likely have the bad actors looking for zero-day exploits, zero-day. And for that reason, these technologies are not open source. So yes, Ledger has firmware that is not open source and that has the possibility of exporting the private key, right? They've said that that's been possible, but they have never said that they have done that until recently. So to simply say that because of this, that ledgers are suddenly insecure is an overreaction, because all other major hardware wallets besides Trezor, have closed source firmware. There, I said it. Just because somebody at tech support said that it's always been possible to export the private keys through a firmware update doesn't mean that they've been doing that, right? They are a company that makes a claim about their product, and the product has been rigorously tested over the years that it does what it says. And if Ledger had been storing people's private keys and stealing their crypto, we would have known by now. Now, you can make the argument that they're like Dr. Evil in his like little island lair, and they're storing everybody's private keys and waiting for that big event where they will one day will suck everybody's crypto out of their Ledger hardware wallets. I doubt that that's a viable scenario, right? First of all, if that happened, they would immediately be found out, right? So not a very good plan. If you're not a very good thief to, yeah. So I, and as I said, we put a level of trust in the company when we use their device, as we do with every other hardware wallet, pretty much. So I don't think that they have been exporting people's private keys on the fly all this time. And I don't think that updating to this firmware is going to introduce a quote-unquote backdoor. It's the same concept as the private key. I cannot sign a transaction without user intervention on the device. Just because now they've allowed user intervention to export the key to their servers doesn't mean that that's a backdoor. It just means that it's one more thing that can only be authorized by the user, just like signing the private key can only be done by the user. Now, people have claimed that this device has been hacked before, and all of those hacks involve someone having physical possession of your device. So as long as you have the device in your hand, then there is no backdoor. Okay, so that's all I'm gonna say. I'm blue in the mouth trying to explain this. I hope this works. I think I was talking while I was trying to enter my PIN, but I got it. Okay, so here we go. We got our device. Let's go to my ledger. Let's allow this. And let's go ahead and run this firmware update. All right, I think Dan already did, yeah. All right, so here we go. Ledger Recover starting today. You can subscribe to Ledger Recover, which you can't. I don't know why they, well, maybe you can now. I don't know. Well, I'm not going to, but apparently you can now. I don't know what date this is. Ledger is currently compatible with, Ledger Recover is only compatible with Ledger Nano X. This is a Ledger Nano X. Let's go ahead and do this. And the day I lose all my crypto, mysteriously, off this Ledger device, I will come and tell everyone I was wrong. Until that day, I will continue to say that it requires user intervention. You guys just wait. And I swear to God, if my crypto disappears, I will come hat in hand and admit to you that I was wrong. The day all my crypto disappears. confirm install on Ledger. Okay, so I hit both buttons. I gotta advance over one and then confirm. All right, and then at some point I'm going to need to re-enter my PIN. And there we go. All right, so I'll re-enter my PIN. All right, so I took the plunge. Now, the device, all the apps are off the device, but there is a reinstall app. You can't see it, it's behind me. Yeah, there you go. See it, reinstall apps? Okay, that worked. So I'll click that, and it's going to reinstall every app that was on there before. I have to authorize that. Now, there are a lot of people out there claiming, oh, they've released, this firmware update is, this is a backdoor that's being installed. Well, no one person at Ledger has the ability to push firmware updates out. So it requires multiple authorizations from multiple people at the company. So if there was a bad firmware update, it would have to be done with the full knowledge of everyone at the company, right? So they would have to, as a company, be criminals, number one. And they would also, as a company, need to, you know, make sure that nobody in the inner circle reveals that they're pushing bad firmware updates. I mean, it's just a weird way of thinking about the world, right? I don't know. I mean, if you don't trust anybody, anywhere, anytime, more power to you. But unfortunately, we put a level of trust in just about anything we do, and we have a risk assessment in just about everything we do. We step outside our house, and we get in our car and drive down to the beach with the full knowledge that we might get into a car accident. But we're willing to take that risk because we want to drive down to the beach, right? We don't like hide in our houses because we're worried we're going to have a car accident, right? And the chances of you having a car accident are pretty high, right? For through no fault of your own, right? So we take risk assessments about everything we do, right? So the same with crypto. As I mentioned, there are no foolproof crypto solutions. There are highly secure crypto solutions that are difficult to use. And so in that sense, they're not good solutions. A good crypto storage solution must include security, usability, and affordability. Those are my three. I'm sure there's others. But we can't judge completely on this unattainable idea of security that doesn't even exist in the real world. Everyone seems to think it does, but it doesn't. And to fault Ledger because, you know, we don't trust them, we could say the same about every other crypto wallet out there, most of them, right? And the ones that are so complicated we can't figure out how to use them, or they're too inconvenient to use, aren't really good solutions either. There, I said it again. At some point, you update the firmware or use another wallet. Yeah, that's true. I'm not saying that. I think the general consensus in the crypto community is that now that we know that hardware wallets can't be 100% cryptographically trusted, which most people that were real crypto enthusiasts already knew this, but there was a large part of the community had always believed that the hardware wallets were 100% secure, safe and secure, and then rude awakening, you know, someone told them, hey, there's no Santa Claus, you know, that crypto hardware wallets, there's a level of trust involved in a crypto hardware wallet. Now they have to make a choice. Do you want to stop using Ledger, or, you know, do you want to keep using Ledger? Do you want to choose a different wallet? That's a black and white choice. But I think the general consensus now that we know this is that people should spread their assets across multiple platforms, right? So don't keep everything in your Ledger. Maybe keep some in your Ledger, some in your Trezor, some in your Keystone, some in your Engrave, some in MetaMask. You know, spread your assets out is the general consensus. I'm pretty sure that's the general consensus in the crypto community, is that, you know, we don't put all our trust in one wallet. We know we can't trust wallets 100%, so we give them a level of trust that we've always been giving them, but now our strategy is maybe don't put all our eggs in one basket. Maybe move some of our assets to other platforms, just in case. That seems to be the most sane solution, as opposed to just throwing the Ledger out and burning it. Yeah, I mean, like I said, I don't agree with this recovery service. I'm never going to use the recovery service, but I'm going to continue to trust the hardware wallet itself. But by the same token, I'm also exploring other options. I really like the Engrave. I might store some of my assets in the Engrave. I like the Nifty for storing NFTs. I've always used a Trezor. I always have a little bit in my Trezor. I've got assets spread across several hardware devices. Yeah, there's a level of risk in everything we do, And we've always trusted hardware wallet companies. We just didn't realize it until we were rudely awakened. But, you know, life goes on, right? We adjust our strategy. As Paul said, either you stay with a ledger or you choose something else. Okay, Paul updated this a while back. Yeah. Let's see. Are we done with the reinstalling of the apps? Yeah, looks like it. All right, so I have all my apps back on here. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you'd like to subscribe to my channel, I would appreciate it. When you subscribe, there's a little bell that you can click that will allow you to be alerted whenever I post new content. Once again, thanks for joining me and hope to see you again soon.